Assalamualaikum and very good evening. Alright, so today I will start with our lecture on topic 9. And as you can see from here, this is about the influence of the culture and the subcultures on the consumer behavior. Okay. So still adjusting here. Alright, so I hope that I hope that everybody are in a good condition, stay healthy at home. Right. So what is in topic 9? It's about the influence of the culture and subcultures on the consumer behavior. And as you can see, the topic objective, okay, after studying this topic, the student should be able to, number one, we will define on the culture and its dimension, and 9.2 explain the invisible hand of the culture, and 9.3 is about explain the culture is dynamic. As I mentioned before, culture is dynamic. Dynamic is meaning as defined the changing. Okay, the changes is they have a changing in the culture from one time to time, and discuss the measure of the culture. Right. As you can see from the X, okay, this is about the convenience in the food preparation. So, as you can see from the brand name BEHAVIOR-BUS2238 original baked beans, maybe this kind of brand is not so familiar in Malaysia. But let's say I told you about the brand news, okay, and I stated also in the slide according to the culture in Asia as a canned food, okay, from IDRB. This is the convenience for those who are busy working, they can use this kind of the products. Okay, so 9.1 is about definitions of the culture. Right, so what is culture? Okay, if you ask me about what is the culture, culture is about something like the different of ways, attitudes, combinations on how you behave when you believe from one custom to another society. Okay. So as you can see from the slide, the sum total of the learned beliefs, values, and the custom that serve to regulate the consumer behavior of the members of the particular society. So we need to see, we are talking about the sum total, the combinations of the different variety. For example, like in Malaysia, we have the multiracials, right? We have Malay, we have Indian, we have Chinese, we have the other ethnicity. So these kinds of, they have actually revealed their own society, okay? They have their own culture on how they are believed, okay? So as you can see, to understand the culture, just think of the difference between the two societies, how they think, okay? And how they think, and how they act differently. And you can see also, even though they have belief culture, it's not becoming less different from country to country. So in order to identify differences and values and behavior also different, okay? So this is something like theoretical model of the culture influence on behavior. So as you can see, the first from the left side, we have the personal traits, and then it will be rely on the cognitive belief. And then we have subjective culture under the regional, ethnic, religious, linguistic, national, professional, organizational, and also groups. And we have the practical and the values. And also you can see the cognitive belief will reflect the attitudes and the social norms. And then it will reflect to the behavior intention, and also it will depend on the behavior. So I do have this, this one you can actually put into your own shoes. And you can see how you can react when you go and they say you are staying in Malaysia. Okay, so we are might be circling among all the Malaysian, so we will become, this is a norm. But when one day maybe you migrate, or maybe you put your study obviously, let's say, so you will have to adapt with the culture. For example, you are putting your study in Japan, you put your study in US, you put your study in other Middle East country, you have to actually adapt and adopt, okay, on how the way of their belief, how their practice, their values, attitude, and the social norms. Alright, so we move to the 9.2 subtopic, the invisible hand of the culture. So each individual perceives the world through his own cultural lens. So meaning to say, if you ask me how the way I perceive on the culture might be different from how you see the culture. So everybody, every single people, they have differences in their perceptions. Okay? So we often do think about the focus the culture has on the behavior. Sometimes things that seem like the right thing to do. Examples, so things. When you receive gift, they say, you as my students, before your final exam, you want to give some gift to me as your lecturers. So how do we perceive this gift? Is it this gift is perceived as the bribe, or maybe this gift is just a gift? So this is how we look into the different cultures. Certain cultures, they accept this one as a gift, orang kata oli-oli. Or maybe they might say that this is some of the, what we call some bribe, in order to make sure that, let's say, I'm not doing good for my exam, and then I fail. So due to the gift, I alter the decision, and the result from fail to pass. So that is considered as bribe. Huh? So the statement in the slide helps sum up the culture as the lens which people see the world. So different people will have a different way on how they see the world. Okay? So as you can see also in this next slide, it's about lifestyles metrics for the global youth. So we have the in-crowd, the pop memories, network intelligence, yeah, three regions. So this is about the subculture and the pop culture. As you can see the red dots here. Issues like researchers have developed this metric for ages 14 to 24 years. For the segment are as follows. The in-crowd is about privilege enforcement, pop memories with word of mouth rapidly and like individuality. Network intelligence are the hubs of the online social networks and are creative and creative. It's all about informing, adrenaline, and anarchy. So this one, I don't have idea to explain more, but maybe you can have read further on your long notes. Huh? Alright, so in the culture satisfied things, okay, what does the $14 shares really cost? So after that, sum up, okay, also the factory overhead, agent, labor, insurance duties, factory margin, and all total up is $5.67, and it did have a markup price 60% for $14. Okay, this is how the business is done in the apparel industry. So, okay, as you can see, the culture satisfied needs. They have food and clothing, need versus luxury. What kind of needs does culture help satisfy? It helps us decide where to eat, when to eat, what it helps us. Which product we simply must have, that is the what products are luxury like a private plane. Okay, so as you can see in here, we are talking about how those people see it. When they want to have food, then they want prefer local food, or maybe they prefer Western food, or maybe they prefer restaurant, okay, or maybe they need some clothes. So whether they want to use traditional clothes, or maybe they need some what we call something like according to the trend right now, okay, maybe like hipsters, okay, maybe they follow how the Korean styles, for example, and needs versus luxury. We are talking about what is your basic needs, okay, because we are talking about, when we're talking about the basic needs, we are talking about the food, we're talking about the shelter, we're talking about food and things, shelter and the clothes, and it's different the other way around to fulfill your basic needs or to fulfill your luxury, because luxury is talking about the brand name. So we are talking about you want to buy something because you want to have some affordability to buy more. Okay. So many will say no due to the lack of the nutritional value and competing products globally. Okay, if you see from here, this is about the advertisement from Coke. Yeah, they are talking about Diet Coke. So in terms of the culture, do you consider this product to be the good morning beverage? Why and why not? Mostly from the research view saying that even though it's called as a diet coke, it's not appropriate enough as a good morning breakfast or drinks, because yeah, even though it's called a diet coke, it still has some gap, and then somehow it's not appropriate. And compared to the coffee, it's the basic one, like the individual we have said about it, and then we have those Milo drinks, right? So they might say they are disagree not to have this Dihatiku as their main breakfast between the kids. So we move around to the culture is learned, okay? How the culture is learned. Okay, we have the four issues here to be discussed. So the number one, we're talking about enculturation and acculturation. Okay? What is enculturation? See, when we're talking about enculturation, it's about the learning of one own culture, meaning to say you learn about your own culture. So basically it's not easy to learn, okay? But because we are being here, you're young kids, and then from we've been cycle with our parents, so we learn something about the own culture from our parent skills. So we learn about our own culture from the time as four children, as I told you just now. Through both informal and informal learning, we learn how to behave and the difference between right and wrong. Okay, some people, okay, just give you a very basic simple example. When you keep using your hand, fingers, there's nothing wrong, right? In Malaysia, for example. But if you go to overseas, for example, when you eat using your hand or fingers, it's something like awkward to see. Because why? Because they believe that we have spoon and fork. Why we have to use our fingers? Okay, so this is sunnah, right? Okay, so when we're talking about this kind of thing, some perceive is wrong to do. Some perceive is right to do. Okay, because it's about culture. Okay, and the learning of our own culture usually happens slowly over time. Of course, we learn something new every day. Okay, we learn. Of course, we are talking about the process of learning our own culture. And the opposite word for enculturation is called acculturation. Okay, acculturation is the learning of a new or foreign culture. So we need to say we learn other people's culture. So mostly, we're talking about quite often when someone learns. Meaning, I give you a previous example. You are going to further your study in overseas, for example. So you have to cope with how to do it. For example, you go and further your study in Japan. You have to know punctuality. What is punctual? It's about Malay time, Malaysian time versus Japanese time, right? When Japanese say is punctual, should be, let's say, the class start at 8 in the morning. Okay? You have to come to the class 7 o'clock in the morning. Compared to us, even the class start at 8 in the morning, 8 o'clock, but you can come at 8:15, 8:30, and the class is still not started yet, right? So, example. So, this is how the way we learn about the foreign culture, okay? And as you can see from this stated slide, okay, the process of observation can be very difficult, okay? Why is very difficult? Because in terms of difference of age, and an interest and culture and desire to become a part of the new society, it's not easy because we have to learn other people's culture. Okay? And the second issue is about language and symbols. Okay, so what is language and symbols? Okay, so we're talking about without the common language, okay, shared meaning at least. So as you know, English is a lingua franca, okay, the international language that being used in order to communicate to each other around the world. And some say also like Mandarin language, some say Arabic. So for a while, I believe that English is being used, okay? And marketers must choose appropriate symbols in advertising. Of course, if you realize like McDonald's, they use M symbols, and then like Windows, they use like a Windows image, okay? iPhone, okay, they use like Apple company, they use like a bike, Apple, okay, and we have what else, Nike, they use like a mark there, and marketers can use known symbol for the association, of course, okay, because this is simply, okay, people know, oh, this company is representing, this symbol representing of which company, we know who, or this company represent Apple company. There is a strong symbolic nature to the human language. Yes, I agree on this. We use symbol to communicate with each other, and marketers will use the symbol to communicate to their customers. Okay. So we move to the next issue. Okay. So this is the example of the advertisement. We have the flowers and the butterflies here. It's about light bulb. Okay. Okay. And then if you realize they have a bulb inside there. here is the representative of electric product, right? How does the symbol convey the product's advertised benefits? Okay, so the third issue is about ritual. Okay? So what is a ritual? Okay, a ritual is a type of symbolic activity consisting of a series of steps. So when we think about ritual, this is something over the human life cycle, and the marketers realize that rituals often involve the product artifacts. So as you can see, for example, rituals like parties, birthday parties, weddings, graduations, or religious rites of the people, many of those rituals from artifacts and objects, they are important to the day. These rituals might be the overnight of the night, so they have the artifacts that the student absolutely must have. For example, like foods, perhaps, example, birthday parties, they must be gift, a balloon, what else, give, a present, wedding, talking about cake also, and how the bride and groom, their dress, their dress up, their attire, graduation is about, they have their own, what we call, robes, see? And then we have religious rites, for example, like Muslim, when we want to perform our solat, we have to use like the car is very simple. You can use as long as you can cover your aura. In like Roman, we use our turkum. So this is the things and objects that we use to perform our ritual. The selected rituals and associated artifacts. Okay, we have like wedding, as you can see, white gown, something old, something new, something borrowed, something new, the birth of child, so when the baby was born, and we have a silver baby spoon, birthday card, present cake with the candles, pretty wedding anniversary. So we have candle party, card gift, this baby, and how the people celebrating the graduation, this watch, Valentine's Day. Muslim, we don't celebrate Valentine's Day, but this is mostly the world is celebrating candy, card, flowers. New Year Eve, we have like changes. Muslim also don't have this thing, okay, party, friends, trust. And the last one, we have the sharing of the culture. So, to be cultural characteristic, a belief, value, or practice is shared by a significant portion of the society. So when we're talking about the sharing of the culture, they have been divided into two. Okay? We have intragenerationally versus intergenerationally. Okay? Intragenerationally, meaning to say the culture is transferred within the family members. Okay? And example, you see the family members perform for like every 5 times a day. So this is the thing that you learn, okay? From one to side. Your family members, your parents, teaching you how to perform solat. Okay. And intergenerationally, for example, you learn from school traditions. For example, how do we to see your senior, okay, how they dress up. It's totally slowly changed from the first semester up to the final semester. You will grow in according to how the way of your Sunday, okay, look like. Okay. And if you see also here, they say through family, school, houses of worship and media. So we need to see like, even though like, go to our musalla, okay, we go to masjid, we go to mosque, and then we go to like non-Muslim, they go to church, Hindus, they go to Buddhist, they go to their temple. They also have their own, how they perceive and perform, okay, their worships. So you can see from here, a culture cannot exist within one person. There must be a large group, which is so then this is indeed a significant portion of the society. Okay? Alright, so this is about the fashion individual of the young TV advertising sales representative. So this is about L'Oreal, and how they use the thing that you own. I don't want to put it down. So we go with the 9.3. Culture is dynamic. The dynamic meaning is evolving and changing. Evolve because it will mix and the certain factors change culture like technology. Okay, due to most which then the technology. We still can say Selamat Hari Raya, Salam Mubarak to our relatives through using this technology like Zoom, we have Skype, we have video call. And when we're talking about the population shift, this is a kind of generation is changing. For example, according to the research saying that by 2020, Malaysia will become the old generation. Meaning to say, there is a lot of emotional generation at the year of 2020. Baru dua. Ramai nanti akan berusia yang lebih tua pada tahun 2030. 10 years from now. And then, resource shortage, we're talking about limitations of the resources, will also change the culture. Okay? And then, maybe I give some example. If you realize, Malaysia depending a lot to these foreign workers. You can see, you can realize with your own eye, many of those the foreign workers are migrated to our country. You do because our people do not want to do this kind of thing, laborious work. So those people, they are using this opportunity to work in our country. And we're talking about wars. Okay, we're talking about how the country having wars, okay, and then of course this also will change the culture. I give example like Bosnia and Herzegovina. One time ago, the country is having like wars. What happened? Malaysia is adopting them to here to Malaysia, and they learn, okay, about something our culture, and we learn also about their culture. And the changing value, of course, we're talking about the value of the culture will be changing from time to time, and the custom from other country, of course. So we learn from other country as the generation that I told you before. Okay? And we have the last one, 9.4, for the measurement of the culture. As you can see, the red notes there. Measurement techniques are used to track values and social trends for the government and business. Each of will be looked at the individual on the following side. We have the market analysis, consumer work, value measurement instrument. Okay. So what is content analysis? So researchers can look at the magazine, websites, television, commercial, and even blogs to see what changes might be occurring and what value are important. So as you can see here, they are mentioning about the method that systematically analyzing the content of verbal or pictorial communication. So they use the kind of verbal and also some diagram. The method is frequently used to determine prevailing social values of the society. Right, so this is some example of how the culture really is portrayed. And you can see like they have two doors of the refrigerator, and it's evolving right now. The progress, the fish has been super refined. You can have like ice cube there, and you have two doors, you have four, how to freeze and close your fish there. Right, and then with cultural radio is this advertisement stressing. It's about how you want to actually fitness and health, or what is about your low calorie passion for your food. So this is something that could keep here. And then we have consumer fieldwork. We are talking about a field observation. We have natural sensing, subject unaware, and focus observation of behavior. So with the consumer fieldwork, researchers observe behavior, because we're talking about we are monitoring the people and consumer attitude and how to we observe purchasing behavior. So this can be done in the field by activity involving participants to observe their own behavior and belief, and also we have the participation observation. So they have under the value measurement survey instrument, instead of observing the behavior, we also have this kind of like quantitative survey. We have from kitchen values and as list of value and values such samples. So a self-administered inventory of the 18 values, okay, they have personal goals and 18 instrument values. For example, how do we reaching personal goals? And then we have list of the value, a value measurement instrument that asks consumers to identify their most important value from the 9 value, okay, this is under vocation value survey. And we have also the value measurement based on the 2 categories, self-definition and resources. Okay. So you have to read more further in your notebook. Okay, so under that, because we are using the American textbooks, okay, so this is talking about American core values criteria for the value selections. So the value must be pervasive. Okay, what means pervasive? Okay, where a significant portion of the population accept this value. We need to see if you are living in Malaysia, whether the Malaysian is accepted, this value has to be accepted, and we can actually enjoy this value. And the value must be enduring, lasting for the significant period of time, and the value must be consumer related. You see, it helps us to understand what kind of consumption we have. Alright. So this is about the American core values. If you realize, we have 11 values here. So, what is the here? And the two notes here, I have red color here, is focusing on what means focus and also external conformity. We have activity, efficiency, and practicality. Progress. What's mean progress? Progress relates to the fact that people and the society can improve themselves. So meaning to say they have the changes in themselves. Okay, and of course this value will relate to the achievement, success, efficiency, and so practically how you develop yourself. So for example, you move from one career to career. That is career development, career progress. Okay, external conformity. Okay, external conformity relates to the fact that although the consumer lacks freedom of choice and individualism, they all accept the reality of conformity. So you need to see that they use to the freedom of choice and individualism. And how we are talking about humanitarianism, usefulness, fitness, and health. This is a health skill to measure attitudes toward health and others. This is a skill that is used to measure people's health and fitness, that is related to skill that means attitude towards charitable organization. Okay. Helping others, people should be willing to help others who are less fortunate. Okay, for example, you are in this kind of sorry because just now they have some of because I right now in a hospital. Okay, and then help travel people with their problem is very important. People should be more charitable towards others in society, and this is support from others. So, last but not least, I think. Okay, to a shopping culture, is shopping what we do to create value in our life. The younger generation is shopping more. This has an effect on the credit card debt. So in here they say the shop still drop, but it has forced specialty to American pastime. People of all ages view shopping as more than necessity but a hobby, interest, and important part of their life. In some cases, shopping addiction. Right, so yeah, of course when we're talking about this kind of shopping culture, of course there is a banning on using credit card in Malaysia, and then the younger generation is shopping more, of course, and yeah, shopping can create value in our life, right? So conclusion, you have to taste a culture to understand it, and of course this is according to Dottera Parker. So sorry, there is some of the technical, not technical, but some interruptions. I hope you can, due to listening to these lecture notes, audio lecture. Okay, and stay safe, stay healthy, and thank you so much for listening. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.